Roads renamed for local legends. It's been a trend in Tallahassee over the years. This is video from 2021 when the city renamed Gamble Street, which cuts right through the heart of FAMU's campus, after Robert and Trudie Perkins.
Our Tally Back Then segment today focuses on the couple who lived their lives fearlessly in the pursuit of fairness. Here's Delatri Hollinger with the Florida Civil Rights Museum.
This is Robert D. Perkins Sr. and Trudie Chester Perkins, who were Tallahassee's civil rights power couple. He and a friend of his, Charlie Jenkins, they filled their trucks up with black children and took them to play at white parks. And as a result of that action, the city of Tallahassee constructed Jake Gaither Park for Negroes at that time, which was dedicated in 1954. Trudie Perkins was one of the first African-American nurses hired at Tallahassee Memorial Hospital. She and another nurse, Lizzie Smith Dennis, were instrumental in calling out discriminatory practices that were taking place at the hospital. Black nurses were being paid less than their white counterparts, and so they brought attention to that. As a result, they were both terminated from their positions. We're looking at Robert and Trudie Perkins standing in front of the Perkins Service Station and Beauty Salon. Mrs. Perkins had earned her degree in 1944 from FAMU in Beauty Culture. Mr. Perkins earned a degree from FAMU in 1947, and they operated the service station as the only service station in Tallahassee that had three gas pumps that was owned by African Americans. During the Tallahassee bus boycott, the Perkins were instrumental as the only black-owned service station with three pumps for providing gas for those who were participating in carpools. Right. The Perkins were two people who were courageous, who were persistent, who were passionate, and they weren't afraid to stand up against the power structure for what was right. And they should look at them as an example for people that they should become, especially the young people of the community, and they should follow their example with fighting for justice and equality for all people.
That was really a small fraction of what Delatri told me they did in their lifetimes. And add this to the list. After Trudie was fired in the 1970s from TMH, Robert prepared case files alleging discrimination with no previous legal experience. He went to Washington, D.C., and eventually that led to a federal lawsuit against the city of Tallahassee, which owned the hospital at the time. Hollinger says that was key to integrating many of Tallahassee city offices.
Right, and so many people so courageous in making sure that these changes were made.